This is my latest project, and it's called African Ritual. But this time, I included our Black history of where we come from and the cycle of we had our own nation, our own land. And then when we was taken from Africa and put on the slave ship, and from the slave ship to the auction block, to the auction block, to the cotton field, to the cotton field where we fled. And then we have our civil rights leaders. So I'm gonna zoom in on this, so this way you can see it much clearly about what I'm talking about. But this whole picture right here is the African ritual, which is a man and a woman looking down, and they are watching, protecting their community, their children, their family. And so this been getting me a lot of views, love it. It's very attractive, and I have been selling a lot of this. So this also gonna be included into the museum. They just built the new one out in Washington, D.C., and I get that information as well. But let me zoom in on this part right here so this way you can see exactly what I see. Starting from the upper right-hand corner is our nation, and we was king, queens. We had our own land, and we was very rich in that situation. Right below it is when we was enslaved and taken from our homeland and brought to America through the slave ship that you could see next to it. And the left middle above is where we was put on the auction block, and we were stripped of our own language and our own rituals, and then we were sold either in the field or in the house. And right below it is showing you the cotton field where we was enslaved into picking cotton. And from there to our left bottom is when we decided to fled through the Underground Railroad. And right above that is you'll see our civil rights leaders speaking about all this mess that we was going through and we still continue to go through. And the purpose of me exhibiting this particular piece of art is because it's to educate the viewers, educate the young Black people or young people or anyone of their history, because I feel that that's the situation or that's the problem that people are having. Because if you don't know your history and you don't know where you're coming from or where you came from and you're ashamed of it, you won't go any further. You won't grow. Because you got to know where you came from, you got to know your history, you got to know where you stand at now, and how you can educate yourself and others. And so this is the purpose right here, is to educate the viewers, Black, African American, young people, and olders as well, of their history of where they come from, or where they came from, and who they really was, or who they are, and who they represent. And once they can understand their history through art, through my eyesight, and then you can grow better. And so that's what I'm doing right here, is educating, teaching you about your history. Now here's another part of the history as well, is let me take this down, that way you can see this. And I'm also going to zoom in on this particular piece here, so that way the viewer could see this. Okay, this is another part of African-American history, which is my history, is this art right here is a collection of Eric Edwards. And he's an artifact, and these are his collection. He goes all around the world, Africa, and he collects actually artifacts of African pictures. And it tells a history, it tells a story. So, and this particular one right here, as far as education, this is by the Bioli people and the Ivory Coast. And this is the Triangle Slave Market. Now, the reason why I'm showing you this, because when you see pictures like this, is letting you see about our history and our own people that was in bondage or enslaved other blacks for a trade market, for money, for purchases. So it was always these situations, and it educates you about our history. So this is another part of it. And like I said, this is part of Eric Edwards' collection. Okay, before I leave, the information I was going to give you on where I'm going to have my art or this particular art sent to or review, and that would be in the Smithsonian National Museum in Washington, D.C. And you can always look it up on the internet. You just put Smithsonian National Museum in Washington, D.C. They just recently opened up, so there's a lot of stuff that's in there, and I'm very sure that they would please to have something like this in the museum where the public could see it. Thank you for watching my show, and I really appreciate your opinion or any advice or suggestion that you have for what you just seen. And I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
sipatheli gwihe kaya yini le impundulu buyu mtakatifu guye
niwe niwe wapeta mama niwe muloi bana mungu niwe wapeta mama niwe muloi niwe 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 wapeta mama niwe muloi bana mungu niwe wapeta mama
katikona roma chingu
Magotini, wa mutu safika.